Hello everyone, in this class we will see the unit system, how to import the external geometry and mouse operation in ANSYS Workbench. We have already opened the ANSYS Workbench system and in last class we had seen the ANSYS interface. In this class we will see the unit system. So first of all, drag the static structural. Now see the all workflow here. Now in various countries various unit systems are followed. In units, when we click here, there are mainly two unit system which is followed all over the world, SI and metric. And default unit system is selected here is metric, because it is a system default unit system, but as per the our requirement we can change the unit system as well. See how we can change the unit system. Click on to the unit, go to the unit systems, then we can see this particular window. Just make it bigger and now see the SI, metric intern, then US customary, US engineering, then metric gram, metric kg, and all the unit systems are shown here. And see, suppose we are selected metric, in which angle is in radian, weight is in kg, length is in meter. So all these things are means what is the quantity name and their unit is given on the next window. Now what is B, C and D? First of all we will see what is the meaning of B, C and D column. So when we go to the B, it is showing if this particular dot present at any unit system, it is for that particular project. See, now for this particular project, the static structural what we have selected, the metric system is already allotted to it. Then C here shown is C, which is default, means system is already default this particular metric system. And we have allotted the metric system to the our project, and system is also allotted the default metric system. And here we can suppress the system which are not necessary, like in our further lecture we will never use US customary or US engineering unit system. So once I click here, or once I click here, see what happens. I click there and then I close this particular window. Now see, the US customary is now not appear in this particular unit system. So once again we can click here, and we can also make our own customized unit system. For that we have to just click anywhere, means whatever the unit system. See, I click in the metric and I need to duplicate it. Once I duplicated it, then go downward, see the control system, control unit system, double click it and you can give the name whatever you want. Yes, I can give the only custom. Now I give the name custom, I choose that particular custom system and I can make it default also. Now in this custom system, I don't want angle in radian, I want angle in degree. So whatever the angles I will provide it in the future in this particular project, that will be considered in degree, not in radian. If suppose I want length not in meter, I want in mm. So every time length will be considered in mm, mass should be calculated in ton, whatsoever, means whatever unit you want to choose, you can give your custom system through this particular option. And now if you want to delete it, just you have to click it and then you can delete this particular system. Before that, I have to change it to the metric default, then go to the custom, then delete it. It is now not in the unit system list. So in this way we can change the unit system from here, units. Now only three unit system are present here: SI in kg, metric kg meter, in degree Celsius it is measuring the temperature, in metric it is weighing in ton. So default it is metric. In further we can also change the units in the geometry means design modeler also. We will see in later class. So this is a basic thing about the units. Now we will move to how to import the geometry. And now I need to double click on the geometry. Before that I would like to show you, see, it is now green, it is showing ready for next operation. Once I double click here, see, the red mark arises and it is showing starting design modeler. It will take some time, it depends upon your hardware of the system, means what RAM and which processor you are using. Configuration will play very important role while solving the problem. Now I entered into the design modeler. Go to the file and import external geometry file. There I generally save it in the IGS format. You have to save the file into the IGS format. This thing is on the desktop. Double click, bolt in IGS and open it. Once I click there, then generate. See, bolt is bolt. Now we can see the bolt. We can go to the view, and if we close this particular option, then we can also see the frozen. Once we click that frozen body transparency, we can see it solid also. So once we import this particular object bolt into design modeler, now we will see three options: zoom in, zoom out, pan and rotate with use of mouse. Very simple, just you need to scroll in and scroll out for zoom in, zoom out. Just scroll and scroll out so you can see the effect zoom in, zoom out. Just push the scroll, see this particular icon arises, and drag or rotate the mouse so that this particular object will rotate. Just push the middle button, scroll rather I'll say, and see this particular thing is now rotating. Now I want to pan it, push the middle button, control and drag the mouse so that we can see this particular object can easily move or pan. So this is very important option which is required, means mouse operation will play very when we will use this particular option regularly, and all these things, XY plane, ZX plane and all these things we will see in the later classes. So this is all about for this particular tutorial. Thank you.